seconds. That was the scoring drive on that last touchdown as Michael Carter scored from a short yardage situation. Sims, by the way, 10 carries, 59 yards. Coming off a 125-yard performance against Utah in a losing effort last week. Ron Rivers and Tommy Jones deep for Fresno State. We continue in this knockdown drag-out affair. It is Jones, 1 yard deep in the end zone. He will return it to the 10, 15, fumbles the ball. Rainbows have it. It is picked up, and the Rainbows have an excellent opportunity. Joe Davis, the ball, fortuitously, came right in front of him. And Joe, that is a great turnaround for the Rainbow.
That's a big play for Hawaii and a big play for number 5, Joe Davis, who has been out last spring, last year, and this is really his first game since his back injury. And you'll see that the ball just comes out there and bounces right into Joe Davis's hands.
Fresno State has called a timeout. Rainbows trail here with 13:54 left to play in the first half. So this is one of those games that when you map it out on paper and you look at the quality of both teams, you come away with saying, yep, the Rainbows probably can move the ball on offense in the option. Mm-hmm. And Fresno State, yes, they do have outstanding receivers, a very solid ground game, and an outstanding leader in the sophomore quarterback Trent Dilfer. Mm-hmm. They can move the ball. That's exactly what has happened in this game. So the turnover by Fresno State, and the Hawaii Rainbows now have a chance to really cozy up in this game. The series record between these two teams, it is the first meeting in the Western Athletic Conference as Fresno State has joined the conference this year. Fresno State leads overall 13-10-1, and in Honolulu this series is tied at 7-7. The last meeting, 1986, it was Hawaii 24 and Fresno State 13. So the Rainbows have the ball now at the 24-yard line of Fresno State. They trail in this game 23-16. Travis Sims, a single setback. Carter keeps, pitches back. This is Gordon inside the 20. Gordon all the way to the 16-yard line. That play nearly didn't click. Gordon was waiting. His pitch relationship started to really ripen too early.
Well, Brian Gordon almost got in front of Michael Carter there. But good decision by Michael Carter again by pitching the ball.
Sam Watson, number 7, the X-Rainbow, and Johnny Johnson, number 25, there to make the stop.
Well, Jim, what Fresno State is doing is they're not doing too many adjustments on their defense. They're basically playing their 5-2 defense, but now they're bringing their linebackers up on the line and making it look like a 7-man line.
Ball is given to Sims, and they swallow him up immediately. Sims can only get to the 15-yard line, and now James Burton, the ex-Rainbow, and Derek Branch, the current Rainbow, start to push off, and they may have fallen a penalty on Burton. As Derek Branch is clapping his hands, and Burton is not, at least that's the indication that we have. Burton was a Rainbow. He played as a freshman in 1989, then became disgruntled with the program, left. Sam Watson went with him. They laid off a year according to NCAA rules, NCAA transfer rules, and now they are back in Aloha Stadium against their former team playing for Fresno State. A flag was thrown. Here's Jack Baker.
Dead ball, personal foul on the defense. Half the distance to the goal, first down.
So Burton is removed from the game, and Larry Cook, number 37, goes into the game to take his plate. Jim Sweeney apparently will stand for none of that.
Not a smart play by Burton. You know, he wants to come back and he wants to prove to his former teammates that he can play, and then that you guys should have begged the coaches to tell him to keep me here. But that time, not making a smart play at all.
It is now first down for the Rainbows, first and goal to go on the set. Remember, they trail in this game 23-16. Carter keeping at the five, pitches back. Eddie Kealoha spins back to the line of scrimmage. May have gained a yard. That play went nowhere. One of the Rainbows is down.
Well, that time, one of the few times that Fresno State actually played the option well, stretched the option outside, and really covered every single option.
Gene Smith.
That's Michael Carter down.
Yes, Michael Carter gets up, and Michael Carter is limping. Now, the question here is whether Ivan Jasper will come into the game, or will we see Rodney Glover? It will be, let's see, as Carter is helped off. It's going to be Ivan Jasper. Rainbows have the ball, second down, goal to go, the ball at the 6-yard line. So Jasper is greeted with cheers from this home crowd. Carter helped off. He did get a very solid round of applause from the shotgun, Jasper.
And Jim, this looks more like a natural position for Jasper.
Sims to the five, Sims to the four. The hole closed quickly. And that will bring up third down, goal to go, the ball inside the 5-yard line.
Well, Jim, I think the crowd was cheering for Jasper because he does have that throwing ability that Michael doesn't. But, you know, you got to give credit to Michael Carter. He's been operating that option offense really well tonight.
Here come the Rainbows. Johan Bleet to the right. Derek Branch to the left. Slotted inside of Branch is Marlo Lewis. Again, the shotgun. Branch goes in motion. Now he'll come back the other way. They overload the left side. Jasper looking, trying to run. He's at the 10. He's in trouble. And down he goes at the 5-yard line. Credit Fresno State's defense. We see Jason Elam.
Well, Jim, the interesting thing is they're running their shotgun offense, a new offense, down on the goal line. They were in the five, within the five. Surprising that they don't bring out the big bone. I mean, the power eye offense with the two big defensive linemen in the backfield.
Jason Elam. Rainbows setting up on the left side, and now they'll come across Elam, 7 for 11 in field goals, 56 long. That came against Brigham Young here on this field. 23-yarder on the way, and it is good. So the Rainbows get three more. It is 23-19. More action when we come back.
Look for George Strait in his new movie from Warner Brothers, Pure Country.
Hurry into your Hawaiian Chevy Geo dealers and get set to be blown away by big savings. Right now, we're dealing on every Chevy car, truck, and Geo in stock with some of the lowest prices you'll see all year round. Plus, low, low financing and tremendous cash back savings. Getting the Chevy car, truck, or Geo you want can be a breeze, but only if you grab your hat and hurry in now, because deals like these will all too quickly be gone with the wind. Only at your Hawaiian Chevy Geo dealers.
My father was a Democrat, an attorney when he moved to the islands. He was appointed U.S. District Court judge by President Franklin Roosevelt. He was a national committee man for the Democratic Party in Hawaii when everybody else in town was Republican. Now my son is the chairman of the Democratic Party. I'm proud to see that he's carrying on my family's Democratic traditions.
I'm Dennis O'Connor, and I'm running for mayor of Honolulu.
Michael Tsuwai, University of Hawaii assistant coach, works with the offensive line. Now that's going over some blocking schemes. 23 for Fresno State, 19 for the Rainbows. It was 23-8. The Rainbows have cozied up a bit to Fresno State. Michael Carter, a minor ankle twist. He will return to the game. So Jason Elam will kick off. Ron Rivers and Anthony Daigle are deep. And it will go to Rivers at the goal line. He will return it. Leaped over a man at the 15 and is out to the 18-yard line. So the Rainbows taking over on a fumble on the last kickoff. And they were able to get three out of it. That's all. Now Fresno State will have to respond offensively, and the Rainbow defense has to stop Fresno State. They have not done so. Gave up 23 points to the Bulldogs in the first quarter. Sebron flanks to the far side. Harris, also a wide receiver. Guilford looking for Sebron. Short drop, has it at the 20. Struggles out to the 23. Darryl Green made the stop on him.
Well, that time Sebron just running an in route and just stopping there in the seam of the zone. And Darryl Green coming up and making the tackle. But that's the kind of tackle that the secondary needs to make. They need to come up fast and stop them as soon as they make the catch.
Rainbows have no yards passing, none in this game. And Fresno State has no timeouts left in the first half. Ball is given in a sweep near side. This is Rivers out to the 30. He has the first down. 10:26 left to play in the first half. So Fresno State begins marching again.
Well, this Fresno State offensive line really plays low. They're getting underneath the pads of the Hawaii defensive linemen and not really driving them off the ball, but they're staying in front of them and letting the great running backs of Fresno State, like Rivers and Dago and Neal, just letting them pick their holes.
Sebron sets up on the far side. They will probably shift out of this double wing. They do. Marty Thompson, the tight end, flip-flops. He sets up on the left side. Ball is fumbled, kept by the quarterback, and finally, Mika Li'ili'i comes in to make the stop on Dilfer.
That time, Dilfer not getting the ball from, not getting a snap by number 75, Billy Scott, the center. You see the ball stuck there in Scott's hands, not really getting up to Dilfer's hands. Now, an interesting story on Billy Scott, the center, received a knee injury that should have ended his career 2 years ago. But because of his persistence, he's really, he's got a lot of respect from his players in coming back and playing.
Lorenzo Neal has the first down. Lorenzo Neal, that's the first time that he has carried in this game without scoring a touchdown. That's his third carry. He does get a first down. Lorenzo Neal driving the Rainbows crazy in that defensive alignment. Coach Jim Sweeney said yesterday that he really prides his team on a balanced attack. I mean, they can pass, they can run, and the Rainbows have been off balance defensively all this first half. Sebron flanked to the far side, picked up by Zach Odom. Harris is to the near side. He is watched by Demetrius Henderson. First down, ball is given to Rivers, big hole. Rivers, ankle tackle by Darryl Green. If he would have gotten outside of Green, then he would be running almost all alone.
Well, Fresno State goes with the Connor Trey play to the left side. The whole right side of the line pulls. The right guard will kick out Ali Pule with a tackle, pulls inside. Rivers had a big hole there, but Darryl Green makes a nice play of coming up and making a sure tackle.
He would have been running in a pasture had he got by Darryl Green.
That's right, Jeff. Darryl Green, a tough guy.
Neal now, three carries, 43 yards, 14 yards a carry. Gilfer to throw. Being pressured by Ali Pulley. Gets away from Ali Pulley. He's stuck by Randall, Louis Randall. How Randall is playing in this game is beyond me, Joe. But there he is, 51.
Remember, he had a mild separated shoulder last week. And he's playing this week. But, boy, what a great effort here by Dilfer. He escapes the sack here by Ali Pule, hangs onto the ball, and actually gets some positive yards here.
Third down, 5 yards to go, the ball at the 45-yard line. Here comes Fresno State. They have been excellent on third down conversions. In fact, they faced very few third down conversions in this first half. Again, the shift. Gilfer, pass, run, a draw play. With it up the middle is Rivers, and he is very close to the first down. We'll see if they give him forward progress. If they only give him to midfield, that's not enough. And that will be fourth down.
Again, the offensive line just getting in front of the defensive players and just staying in front of them and getting in their way and allowing Rivers to pick the hole. And that time, short of the first down, but nice effort, nice acceleration into the hole.
Fourth down and a half yard to go. Quarterback sneak, we'll see. It is not. Ball is given. And carrying it is Lorenzo Neal. That's enough for a first down to the Rainbow 46-yard line. So just a muscle play that time. And Fresno State coming away with the advantage.
Well, these Fresno State backs have great vision, just able to see the hole and then accelerate into the hole. But they're really able to see the field and know where their blockers are. And that's why they're getting upfield, and that's why they're getting a lot of yards on the ground.
7:07 left to play in the first half. Sebring and Harris are the wide receivers. Sebring to the left, Harris to the right. Gilford with time, throws. Harris inside the 30 to the 28-yard line. That's a first down. So Fresno State on the ground moving. All of a sudden they go back up on top, and they come away with a successful play to the 28-yard line of the Bows. Rainbows have been reeling all night, Joe, defensively, trying to figure this balanced attack. 18-yard gain that time. First down for the Bulldogs on the Rainbow 28-yard line. They come out in a single setback formation. Ball is pitched to the near side to Rivers. Rivers gets to the 25. Junior Tungawai and Demetrius Henderson, they are double teamed him.
Yeah, nice play there by number 8, Joe Shaw. Really coming in there and almost making a tackle for a loss, making a tackle in the backfield. But Junior Tungawai, that's another story, number 91. He had a knee operation 2 weeks ago, and then actually played within the week, and played in the Utah game, and now he's playing Duke tonight.
Again, it is Rivers to the 20. Rivers able to knife behind his blockers, cut into the Rainbow secondary. Walter Santiago comes across to lower Rivers to the turf. Ball just outside the 20. That will bring up third down and 2. 5:32 left to play in the first half. 23 for Fresno State, 19 for the Bows. Michael Roth comes out, and Malcolm Sebring goes back into the game now for Fresno State. Lorenzo Neal is the fullback. Ron Rivers the tailback. Neal sets up on the wing. Sprint to the right. They run to the right with Rivers, 20. Rivers, 15. Rivers, 10. Rivers scores. And there are Rainbow defenders strung out from the 20-yard line in.
Well, Rivers is such a smart runner. He knows how to find his hole. And then he's not only quick and shifty, but he's got some strength, and he shows the strength of his legs there by just driving his legs, not stopping it, then breaking the tackles and then getting into the end zone. But nice effort, nice run there by Ron Rivers.
Second rushing touchdown of the season for Ron Rivers. Derek Mahoney in to try the extra point. He does so, and the Rainbows had yet to stop Fresno State. It is now 29-19. And the question, will Michael Carter be a quarterback for the Rainbows when we return?
You might never get that room picked up or the stereo turned down, but at least you can get those whites completely clean with new UltraSurf plus bleaching action. Its bleaching action out whitens ordinary detergents and removes odors entirely for a complete white, so you can be proud of how your family looks. Even when you hope no one's looking. New UltraSurf Plus Bleaching Action. The complete white.
We're Hawaii's GECC Financial, a unit of GE Capital. Together, we bring good things to life. If you're a real estate developer or buyer, a homeowner, an investor, or business owner, remember our name.
GECC.
To those of you who have a certain image of minivans, Nissan introduces the Quest. It has a V6 engine, so it's more powerful, and front-wheel drive, so it's more nimble and agile than you'd expect a minivan to be. After all, just because you have kids doesn't mean you have to drive a bus. new 7-passenger Nissan Quest. It's time to expect more from a minivan.
Said 29-19, it is not. You add the extra point, and it is 30-19, an 11-point lead by Fresno State, 82 yards in 12 plays. Rivers with a 20-yard run, and the Rainbows still reeling from this balanced attack by Fresno State. In fact, Fresno State has not been stopped by the Bows yet, and they have not punted in the first half. This kickoff will go to Derek Branch at the 2-yard line. Branch trying to get outside, 20, and he's rolled down at the 22. So the Bows will put the ball in play, trailing 30-19. Fresno State comes into this game 39.7 or 39.8 per game. In scoring, the Rainbows at the bottom of the Western Athletic Conference in scoring offense and also total offense.
That's in good news for Hawaii. Number 53, Kelly McGill, is back in the game, who left earlier with a concussion.
Ivan Jasper at quarterback, replacing Michael Carter. Jasper running the option to the 25. Jasper out to the 27. In on the play of five. Second down, 5 yards to go. The Rainbows have 4:47 left to them on this drive in the first half. And they also have the knowledge that Fresno State does not have a timeout. CPB top 20 scoreboard will be flashing at you here in the final minutes of the first half. Second down, 4.5. Kept again by Jasper. Pitches back with the ball is Marlo Lewis. And Lewis gobbled up as he crosses the 32. That's enough for the first down. Today, number 25, Kansas, rallied from a 47-21 deficit to win 50-47 over Iowa State, and possibly another high-scoring affair right here. 30-19, Fresno over the Rainbows of Hawaii, first and 10. Jasper to throw. Does so, down the middle. It is incomplete, intended for Eddie Kealoha. Running with Kealoha was Sam Watson.
That's actually a pretty good play. If you're able to run the option successfully, then you can do your play action passes will work. And that time Jasper had Kealoha open, but couldn't get the ball to him.
Ivan Jasper has played inconsistent football at best. He started very well against Oregon. Ended up in that game only 3-for-10 in passing, although he did hit Branch on a 49-yard touchdown pass. This is Jasper to the 40, explodes to the 45, all the way out to the 48-yard line. That's enough for a first down. So there you see the good side of Ivan Jasper when he makes the right decision. I mean, he can explode into the secondary.
Well, Jim, that time they run the twirl. You see the right slot back acts like he's going to go in motion, but instead turns around and becomes a lead blocker, and that messes up the assignments for the defense. But Jasper taking the ball himself and taking it upfield for first down.
16-yard gain for Ivan Jasper that time. First down for the Rainbows at their own 48-yard line. Triple wide receiver to the left side. Again, Jasper pitches back. It's fumbled by Sims, and he'll fall on it at the 41. Turn the page on Ivan Jasper. That's the bad side. We're mentioning about inconsistency. Ivan Jasper makes a great decision, explodes into the secondary on the play before this, and a bad pitch here. So the line of scrimmage back to the 41. It will be second down. It will be second and 17 for the Rainbows. It almost begs the question of a pass here. Fresno State with 23 points in the first quarter. They've added a touchdown here in the second quarter. And they lead 30-19 over the Rainbows. And now timeout has been called by Hawaii as Ivan Jasper slowly walks to the far side of the field. 2:53 left to play in the first half. Fresno State on top.
A new day is dawning over Hawaii. A new era in automotive excellence. The 1993 Toyotas have arrived. Discover Toyota for 1993 and win a trip for two to San Diego to see the Bows play November 14th. Sponsored in part by Creative Holidays. Includes airfare, hotel accommodations, and tickets to the game. 1993, the dawn of a new era. Rediscover value only at your Toyota dealers of Hawaii.
When Russ Keeler sold his millionth piece of original recipe, he had a Colonel Lookalike contest. How better to celebrate the most famous chicken ever cooked? Made with 11 herbs and spices, original recipe can't be duplicated. It's what all the lookalikes ate, including the winner, whose resemblance was uncanny.
And now you can get 2 liters of Pepsi free when you purchase a 10 or more piece bucket of the Colonel's chicken.
In Lake Edna or your neck of the woods.
Welcome to your Ben Franklin store in Hawaii. Convenience with a personal touch.
Yes, it's another Ben Franklin craft store, now in Mapunapuna, where you'll find more craft supplies than ever before in one location. It's the largest craft store in Hawaii, conveniently located on Pa'a Street right in the middle of Honolulu. So head for Hawaii's craft headquarters, Ben Franklin, now in Mapunapuna.
Convenience with a personal touch.
Hard to describe. You got me on this one. It's full of stuff.
Hawaii's very own 13.
Let's take a look at Jim Sweeney. You're not going to find many head coaches teaching techniques on the sideline. Well, what's coach here? He's a, hey, that's good technique, coach. I mean, what a coach, Jim.
He is.
Really gets involved with the players, and you talk to all of his players, and they just love Coach Sweeney.
I'd like to meet the salesman. Sold him that shirt and said, this is you.
Yeah.
Jasper throws long up the sideline for Branch. It is overthrown. Burton running side by side. Burton, the ex-Rainbow, and he will take the accolades or non-accolades from the crowd as he trots back to his position in the defensive secondary of Fresno State.
Well, he should be happy. That was good coverage on Branch. You're not going to find too many cornerbacks staying with Branch. Branch, a very fast wide receiver. But Burton loves to play bump and run. He'll come up and play you man-to-man. He'll come right up on the line and bump you and then stay with you.
Jasper now 0 for 2 in passing. Overthrown his receivers both times. Third down and 17. And now the whistle blow again with the 2:23 left to play.
I think the clock was running. And it's supposed to stop on the incompletion.
So Jack Baker probably will request some time to be put back.
Timer, reset the game clock. 2:43.
Now it's back at 2:43. And we are ready to begin. It's the clock guy. There's the clock guy. He's up on the press level. Third down, 17 for the Rainbows, and from the shotgun, Jasper, some movement, no flag. Jasper running for his life. Throw sideline pattern, again overthrows the receiver, and Watson really levels. And we will have, I believe, a personal foul on Sam Watson. Watson leveled Johan Buit after the ball had whistled over his head.
Well, the ball is uncatchable. I don't think it's an interference call. I think it's a personal foul call. And it looked like the referee was going to give Watson a break, but then Watson probably said some words that didn't make the referee too happy.
Here's Jack Baker once again.
Dead ball, personal foul on the defense, 15 yards, first down.
So the two ex-Rainbows, Burton and Watson, have been called for personal fouls in this game.
And one note is Watson did not play for the Rainbows. He came here as a prop 42. And he sat out his first year, then transferred with James Burton to Fresno State.
Burton did play in 1989, but Watson was in the program. First down for the Rainbows following that personal foul penalty. Ball is kept by Jasper, and with the long legs, he gets galloping inside the 40 to the 36-yard line. 2:27 left to play. Rainbows trail 30-19 here in the first half. Gene Smith, number 13, from Lemoore, California, tied with Zach Ricks for the lead in sacks with four coming into the game. He made the tackle for Fresno State. Second down and three. Ball at the Fresno State 36. Ball is given up the middle to Sims, very close to the first down as he cracks to the 32.
Well, in their option game, the quarterback, or Jasper Carter, has not been giving the ball to Travis Sims in the last couple plays. And so it's softening up the defense. They're thinking perimeter. And that time, Jasper making a good decision of giving the ball to Travis Sims up the middle.
Inside of 2 minutes to play here in the first half. Fresno State leading 30-19. Ollie Myrick to the far side and Cramps to the near side. Back to pass is Jasper. He'll run. It opens up for him. He's inside the 25.
Oh, nice move.
The 20. Chased from behind and finally ankle tackled at the 13. So Ivan Jasper looked downfield and all of a sudden wide open spaces.
Well, good decision here by Jasper. Had some time to throw the ball. Didn't see anybody open. Decided to take the ball himself and really just outruns three, four Fresno State defenders before being brought down there by Sam Watson. But nice gain and good momentum play for Hawaii Rainbows.
18-yard gain for Ivan Jasper. The ball just inside the 15. They put it on the 14. First down. Jasper again keeps pitches back. This is Eddie Kealoha inside the 10. And Eddie Kealoha swallowed up as he gets to about the 7-yard line. Gene Smith again making the stop for Fresno State.
And the good thing about the option working tonight is you're able to get that man right there in your picture, right there in your screen, number 38, into action. He has been silent pretty much all season long, and now he's getting a lot of opportunities to run that ball. And when he runs that ball, the boy can fly.
Joe, when the Rainbows previously have been down here, and we've seen it all season long, they go to that power eye. We've not seen it in a while. Second down, two for the first down. Jasper pitches back with the ball is Sims. Touchdown!
But this play is a 17-12. The left slot back acts like he's going to go in motion, comes back, becomes a lead blocker. Then Sims becomes the pitch man. And there you see Hawaii outnumbers Fresno State on the left side. And Travis Sims pretty much just walks in untouched.
So Travis Sims scores. And for Sims, in the scoring touchdowns on the season, that is his second. First coming last week against Utah on a 65-yard touchdown romp right up the middle. Travis Sims scores. Rainbows again inchworm back close to Fresno State with 1:07 left to play. And the Rainbows, the question here, Joe, whether they go for two or whether one.
I think they're going to go for two, Jim. I think they're two for two. They're going for the two-point conversion. So, but I would love to see that power eye come in, Jim. I haven't seen that in a while. And with that power in, with the two big defensive linemen in the backfield acting like blockers, I mean, it's almost automatic getting into the end zone.
Rainbow's able to score the two-point conversion on the last attempt here on the pass into the end zone to Sims. So the Rainbow's going for two. Jasper asking for quiet. From the shotgun. Jasper. Beam pressure comes back, throws, two-point conversion. Marlon Lewis. Jasper looked right, and all of a sudden came back to the left side, and Marlon Lewis was there. It is now 30-27.
Well, Hawaii overloads the right side, and then Jasper rolls to the right side. Marlon Lewis playing the right slot back, just sneaks underneath the Fresno State coverage on the backside and finds a hole. Jasper finds him, and touchdown for the Rainbows.
What a game. I mean, if you like offense, this game has been, I mean, it's been a military campaign. George Patton, this is George Patton football. I mean, just get out there and go as far as you can, as well as you can. 78 yards on 11 plays. Sims scoring his second scoring touchdown of the season. And so the Rainbows will kick off to Fresno State, a team that in their own right, they have not had to punt the ball, but the Bows are back in it. It is 30-27.
Well,
it was 23-8 at one point at the end of the first quarter. Rainbows now have scored 19 points in the second quarter. Fresno State has scored 7, and it is 30-27 in favor of the Bulldogs. You know, with 107 left, there could be an onside kick here. Well, I'm wrong. A ball is taken by Ron Rivers. He's at the 20. Slides and slips his way to about the 23. So it will be first down for Fresno State. 1 minute and 1 second left to play in the first half.
That's pretty good coverage there by the Rainbows. Got some crazy guys running down full speed and just sacrificing their bodies, like Robert Blakeney and Junior Favai on that play.
So Trent Dilfer leads the team to the line. Daigle and Lorenzo Neal splitbacks behind him. Seaborn and Harris are the wide receivers. Also, Marty Thompson is flexed out from the line, the tight end. Dilfer looking, looks down the middle. Now he'll run. Being chased by Tanavasa. 30, 35-yard line, steps out at the 35. That is enough for a first down. And that stops the clock with 52 seconds left, and that is the elusiveness of Trent Dilfer. And remember, what? This young man at 6'5", 225, he's a load, and he's quite a leader out there. Only a sophomore.
Jim Dilfer had to scramble there because as you watch the secondary of Hawaii, they've got everybody covered here. Well, pretty much, you got the middle there. But you see the defensive back on the top of the screen could have made the adjustment to get him.
Thompson open on the last play. Dilfer looks to Thompson, checks off, being chased, and he's sacked. Sacked by Tase Faumui. For Faumui, that's his second sack of the year.
The big man from Farrington High School.
Now remember, Fresno State has no timeouts. And the clock ticking away, 30, 29, 28. And the Rainbows may call a timeout here. Jack Odom went over to the head linesman and called a timeout. So the Rainbows will take the timeout with 30 seconds left. Tase Faumui.
You get to look at that nice back there. Very muscular guy. And you see him drive his man backwards and just out hustles him and hustles to Dilfer and makes the sack here. But that's, you know, you talk to the offensive line coaches of Utah, and I talked to the offensive line coach last night of Fresno State, and they'll talk about is that front three of Hawaii, and especially about number 99, Tase Faumui.
That was your coach, huh, Mike Hill?
Mike Hill, who coached me my freshman, sophomore year here. But Tase Faumui is so quick up the ball.
He's one of the Sole brothers on that defensive line. Tase Faumui, Tanavasa, and Junior Tangoai.
Not the Sole brothers, huh?
No,
Sole brothers.
The Sole brothers. 30-27. Rainbows huddling around their coaches at the far side. Joe, this has been a tremendous first half. I mean, when you think about it, these two teams have been up and down the field against each other. We've seen passes, we've seen runs, we've seen outstanding performance. And the Rainbows way behind at the end of the first quarter, 23-8. They've scored 19 points here in quarter number two to cozy up to Fresno State. But we're not done yet. 30 seconds left. Ball is given up the middle to Lorenzo Neal, breaking tackles, taking hits. Out over the 35 to the 36-yard line. So on second and 13, he's able to make it third down and 9.
Well, Faumui almost made another big play, knifing his way in between blockers, nearly making a tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
Boy, what adjustments at halftime. like to be a fly on the wall in the locker rooms of both teams. That will be the final play of the first half. An outstanding action-packed first half on the part of both teams. I mean, when you want action, this has been the half of the year. 30 for Fresno State, 27 for the Rainbows of Hawaii.
The great things about the Pagoda never change. We still welcome you with gracious Kama'aina hospitality. The Pagoda restaurant is still a family favorite. And LaSalle is the place for great seafood. But that doesn't mean we've stopped getting better. The new Sacy Bone is making banquets more beautiful than ever. And our completely refurbished guest rooms are making you feel more at home than ever. The Pagoda, an old friend that just keeps getting better.
My name is Alan He. I am an environmental aide with Hawaiian Electric Company. And we do coral studies outside of the Kahe power plant.
Okay, I'm going in there.
Okay. And we make sure that the plant is not endangering the coral growth out there.
This is our paradise. I mean, that's what we live for, the ocean.
Hawaiian Electric is trying to do their part to protect the environment. Because once you ruin the environment, it's gone forever.
Sunday.
You need to head back all the way.
Take a trip inside the mind.
You're in good hands now, my friend.
Of Great Scott. All new episodes Sunday.
Hi, I'm Cher. Singer, actress, slut.
The bad boys of comedy take a look at infomercials, and it won't be pretty. And all new in living color. Then, Joey is a ladies' man until he runs into a jealous boyfriend. Will Rock bail his little brother out? You'll find out when we do on Rock Live. And meet Al Bundy, gas attendant.
Well, hello there, Hobby.
It's Service with a Smile on Married with Children following Rock Live Sunday.
Flashes of brilliance have been sweet promises of the future to Rainbow fans this season. Can the Wahine finally evolve into a cohesive unit in their first ever meeting with Notre Dame? Find out this Thursday and Friday at 8:05.
I'll be there.
We'll be there.
Wahine Volleyball on KHNL.
Thursday, Friday.
See you there.
Well, if you like action, Joe, if you like action, this first half of tonight's game between Fresno State and Hawaii was all action. Fresno State never had to punt. They were up and down this field. They scored 30 points in the first half. They scored 23 points in quarter number one. Rainbows, though, responded. They showed that they had character. They showed they had pride. They came right back. It's 30-27 at halftime. Big guy.
Well, Jim, I'm very impressed with Fresno State's running game, especially in running back Lorenzo Neal. I mean, this guy can, he sets up his blockers really well. And you can see here that as Dilfer gives the ball to Lorenzo Neal, he just sets up his block and breaks tackles and just really just a shifty back. And he's not a small guy. He's a big man. And for the Rainbows, I like the way Michael Carter has been running the option. He's been really poised. He's really reading the defense as well. And he's getting the ball upfield. Now, the thing with Carter, concern for him is his injury to his ankle and if he's going to come back. But Jasper probably take care of that problem. Now, Charlie Jones has done a really good job on special teams for Fresno State in breaking that big run.
This was incredible. This was an incredible punt return. Once he got to the wall, it was just about all over.
And again, Matthew Harding, number 23, making a mistake of coming inside rather than keeping his containment. But Charlie Jones is dancing down the sidelines and getting into the end zone.
So when you take a look at this first half, you were mentioning how Carter was running the option. What about Ivan Jasper? He comes into the game and all of a sudden he supplies a little magic. He supplies a little energy to this offense.
Well, what Ivan brings to the offense is the passing threat. And what it does is loosens the defense. The defense loosens up. They don't come up as much because they know that Ivan Jasper can throw the ball. So it really softens the defense. And then Jasper can also run the ball really well. So he's really doing a fine job of running the option offense.
30-27 at halftime. Fresno State ahead of the Rainbows of Hawaii. And we will now go down on the field and take a look at the Mililani High School band, the Trojans from Mililani, Oahu. Thank you.
This KHNL sports presentation is sponsored in part by Surf Laundry Detergent and by Power Stick Deodorant and Antiperspirant.
Sunday, get ready for Amish Studs.
I was impressed with his incredible plowing ability.
On an all-new Ben Stiller Show, Sunday before In Living Color.
Sunday, meet Al Bundy, gas attendant.
Well, hello there. Habib.
It's service with a smile on Married with Children. And Herman's boss wants a date.
I'm sure you and Mr. Bracken will hit it off. Hello?
And he's going to need some help.
Could you fix Bracken up with a hooker?
An all-new Herman's Head. Then, it's Neil's worst nightmare. Alicia meets his family.
Back when the kids were really small.
And Neil had the cutest little
mom. An all-new Flying Blind after Married with Children and Herman's Head Sunday.
It's about finding your friends, finding your future, and finding your one true love.
Thursday at 8:05 on KHNL 13.
Without warning and no explanation, an experiment in terror has begun.
I've been in this room before.
We've all been here before.
Have crew members been kidnapped and memories erased?
I need to know if anyone comes on or off this ship.
It looks as though your arm has been severed and then reattached.
And will they be sacrificed as human guinea pigs?
Commander Riker has been taken from the Enterprise.
On an all-new episode of Star Trek, The Next Generation.
Tuesday night at 7 on KHNL 13.
In what could possibly be subtitled To Each His Own, the Rainbows and the Bulldogs of Fresno State both have succeeded in the first half. Both have 16 first downs by various means. Rushing yards, the Rainbows with the advantage there. They have absolutely no passing yards. And you can see that balanced attack by Fresno State. 165 rushing, 143 passing. Time of possession, well, almost even there. Now you see the turnovers. That turnover led to one field goal, and the Rainbows trail by 3 points as we start the second half. So you see, keep the faith on the island of Kauai. Rainbows are wearing green K's on their helmets. And you see Jim Sweeney looking on as he's about ready to start the second half. The winningest coaches by percentages in the last 10 years from 1982 to 1992, you see Jim Sweeney third, Fresno State, a 771 percentage over the last 10 years. This Bud Fact brought to you by Budweiser, reminding you to know when to say when. Derek Mahoney, very busy in the first half, will kick off for Fresno State. Deep for the Rainbows, Matthew Hardy, number 23, Derek Branch, number 87. And Mahoney will boot it. It will go to Branch at the four. Gives it on a reverse to Hardy. Gets the ball. 20, 30, 40. He could be gone. 50. They may not catch it.
See ya.
20, 10, touchdown. Play by the Rainbows, a stunner to open up the second half. And for the second time in this game, the second time the Rainbows have the lead. Elam will come in to try the extra point. What a play to open the second half. The Rainbows go deep into their playbook and they execute it perfectly. And Matthew Harding, who can run across the room and turn out the light before it gets dark, that's exactly what he did on that play.
Well, obviously, Hawaii coaches made an adjustment here. They noticed that the Fresno State coverage team is just closes down, and so they run the reverse and give the ball to Matthew Harding. And again, he runs the 100 meters in 10-4. That is world-class speed. And there you see nobody catches him. No way. He just runs and trots into the end zone untouched.
So the little guy does it again. You go back to the BYU game, a 67-yard pass to set up the winning touchdown. And all of a sudden here, He ends up on the end of a night. They're calling it a 97-yard kickoff return. He had a little help from Derek Branch, an excellent handoff. But when he gets into the open, no one catches him. And the crowd reacting to the replay as he looks up and enjoys it all over again electronically.
And Matthew Hardy getting congratulated by his teammates and also by his coach, Buzzy Preston. And what a way to open up the second half, Jim.
It is 34 for the Rainbows, 30 for Fresno State. And turnabout could be fair play here. 87-yard return by Fresno State. The Rainbows respond with a 96 or 97-yard kickoff return. We've had a little bit of everything in this game. Rivers and Daigle deep for Fresno State. This game far from over. Elam kicking off, waiting for it will be Rivers at the goal line. He will not return it. Fresno State will put the ball in play at the 20. Seven-yard kickoff return, 34 for the Rainbows, 30 for Fresno State. The Rainbows have the lead, as I mentioned, for the second time early in this game in the first quarter. That seems like ages ago with all the things that have gone on this field. The Rainbows led 8-7 following a two-point conversion. Trent Dilfer is at quarterback. Again, Fresno State shifts. Dilfer gives it on a delay. Dancing up the middle into the secondary is Rivers, 25. Rivers all the way out to the 29-yard line, and penalty flags have flown. Darryl Green making the stop in the secondary for the Rainbows. Very elusive running backs, Ron Rivers and Lorenzo Neal.
Well, Hawaii's got the momentum on this, their side right now, and Hawaii's defense has got to come in and stop Fresno State's offense from making first downs. They've got to stop them and make them punt.
Chuck Baker saying the penalty for holding. That moves the ball back inside the 15. They put it on the 12-yard line where it will be. Still first down. But now it is first and 20.
That could be a big factor to the penalty yards. Fresno State already having four penalties for 42 yards, and Hawaii with zero.
Call it first and 18. The ball is up the middle. With it is Lorenzo Neal, headbutting his way across the 15 out to the 19-yard line. That will bring up second down and 11.
That time Fresno State going with the counter trade play to the right side. The left side of the line pulls. And then they get the ball in the deep in the backfield, the running back, and he gets time to read his blockers. But that time Hawaii able to stop him short of getting a 5-yard gain.
Rivers 10 carries in the first half, 69 yards. Neal 5 carries, 51 yards. Seabrum cannot hold on. Demetrius Henderson making the hit, the true freshman.
Yeah, and he should be happy.
It was intended for Malcolm Seabrum. Seabrum was in position to make the catch. The ball was there, and then it popped out.
Coach Lumpkin said that this guy, Demetrius Henderson, has got the potential to be one of the best defensive backs to play here at the University of Hawaii.
Gilford now 9 for 14, 143 yards. No touchdowns in this game. He has been sacked once. Again, the shift. Big play here, third down and 11. Fresno State's been outstanding in third down conversion. Guilford hit as he throws. It is out of bounds. It'll bring up fourth down.
And Jim, that time you can credit the secondary of Hawaii. No receivers were open that time. Also, Tase Famui almost getting in there and getting the sack along with Junior Tangawai.
Derek Branch deep for the Rainbows. They lead 34-30. It has been a topsy-turvy game, a real inchworm kind of affair. One team than the other with the momentum. Coming up, waiting for the ball to bounce. And the ball goes toward the side and goes out of bounds at the Rainbow 47-yard line. First down for Hawaii at the 47. The Rainbows open this second half in a shocking development. 97-yard kickoff return. We'll be back.
Obviously, these guys knew a lot about Bud. But was it possible they learned it all on TV?
I think it was on TV.
That Bud, that's beer.
We watch TV. We've never seen this stuff.
Budweiser beer, the king is second to none.
Exclusive Beechwood aging gives you a taste and drinkability you find only in Budweiser.
I mean, how could we have missed it, Paul?
Maybe you guys should get out more.
Are you guys having it your way? They're in trance, they're having it their way so much.
I love this place!
Look, they're all four of them are staring. No, you can't have any. If you want some breakfast, you have to go to Burger King. You can't have mine.
It's breakfast at Burger King.
No, get off. You see, George Rachel was like, give me that. Liquor sandwich for 99 cents?
Does that sound like a good deal to you, Abe?
Yeah, man, it sounds like a peachy deal to me.
Abe's smart man. And 99 cents per sandwich.
Hey, you guys having it your way?
Right away.
Mm-hmm, they love this place.
If you know an exceptional youth sports volunteer, show your appreciation by nominating him or her for the Times KHNL Most Valuable Volunteer Award. Pick up your entry blank at any Times supermarket and enter there, or mail your entry to Most Valuable Volunteer, KHNL 13. Selected entries win a special gift pack. Then in April, one entry will be selected for the grand prize of a cruise to Mexico. The Times KHNL Most Valuable Volunteer Award. Enter today.
13-20 left to play in the third period. The Rainbows leading 34-30. Fresno State led at halftime by a score of 30-27. 34-yard punt by Mahoney. Rainbows have the ball at their own 47-yard line. Derek Branch comes out to the near side. Johan Vuit to the far side. Sims is the running back. Keeping the ball as Jasper pitches back. With it is Brian Gordon, breaking tackle, 40. And Gordon is bumped out of bounds at the 37-yard line of Fresno State. James Burton may have saved something much more serious. Well, he bumped out Gordon.
That's actually some nice blocking up front by the offensive line. And nice decision by Jasper to pitch that ball to Gordon. And Gordon breaking some tackles by Sam Watson and Johnny Johnson for first down.
16-yard gain for Gordon. Now Jasper goes out. He may have been injured on the play. They help him out, and Michael Carter has come into the game. Boy, you talk about a turn of events here. I don't know whether Jasper is hurt. They are taking him toward the bench. He may have had his bell rung. Ball is kept by Carter. Chase pitches back, and with it is Marlo Lewis. And Lewis is swallowed up inside the 35 on first down. Gain on the play of 3 yards, second down and 7 for the Rainbows. Wendell Valentine, and they are very high on Wendell Valentine. Jim Sweeney said that number 49 for Fresno State, the outside linebacker, has National Football League potential. He made the stop on that last play, second down and 7. Michael Carter back in at quarterback. Rainbows have had no yards rushing in this game. Carter keeps pitches back. This is Eddie Kailoha getting a block from Lewis. 30 out of bounds at the 22-yard line. Johnny Johnson forced him out of bounds across the way. Now the Rainbows get into the tough yards on this field.
Jim, interesting. Fresno State defensive line, if you get a chance to look at their defensive line, only one guy is in his four-point stance. Everybody else is up playing like a linebacker, and that might be giving Hawaii offensive line an advantage by getting under their pads.
First down at the 22 of Fresno State. Ball is given up the middle to Sims. Bumps to the 20. He really took a hit.
And Jim, on the last play, Marlon Lewis laid a nice-looking block.
Chris Peters there, credited with the stop for Fresno State. The player from each team will be honored at the end of tonight's game for going beyond the call. GTE Hawaiian Tel will make a contribution for scholarships at the University of Hawaii. Second down and 8. Ball is kept by Carter, and he's tackled immediately. Boy, what a play. Number 52, Chris Peters from Redding, California. Peters comes in. We said that he led the team in tackles. That's a reason why. Came in with 57. He redshirted last year because of an ankle injury. Well, he's back this year.
Now watch the defensive front. You see everybody up in a linebacker stance except the nose guard. And this doesn't happen much, but Peters comes from the backside to make the tackle there on Carter. You can blame number 53 there, Kelly McGill, for not closing down and scooping correctly.
From the shotgun, Carter to throw. Remember, now a penalty flag is thrown. Wonder if the Rainbows got that playoff in time. That may be delay of game. Jack Baker, the veteran official.
Dead ball, false start on the offense. Third pass.
One of the linemen, I believe, moved. That does not bode well for the fortunes of the Rainbows here in the third period, even though they lead 34-30. Boy, an electrifying start to this second half. 97-yard kickoff return. It went to Branch. Reverse handoff to Matthew Harding. And it was a joyous romp through the white shirts all the way to the end zone. Johan Vliet to the far side. To the near side is Branch. Big play here. Third down, 13 from the 25. Carter looking. Throws for the end zone for Branch.
Ooh.
Overthrows him. Branch had a step on James Burton. Again, the ball was thrown high, and again, the Rainbows, will remind you, have no yards passing in this game. That will bring a fourth down and a field goal try by Jason Elam straight on. They put the ball down. We'll call it the 32-yard line. This is a 42-yard attempt. It is kicked. It is on its way. This has, boy, he could have gone 50. Easy.
Or 60.
Jason Elam, maybe, just maybe, the premier field goal kicker in the nation. 37 for the Rainbows, 30 for Fresno State. Much more to come.
If you're dragging yourself home at the end of the day, you need a beauty rest. A beauty rest by Simmons recharges you with independent pocketed coils, energized to firmly support every inch of your body. Nothing makes your day like a beauty rest night.
You need a beauty rest.
Shop for quality Simmons bedding at all Oahu Sears locations. Ala Moana, Pearl Ridge, and Windward Mall.
Once upon a time, there was only one long-distance company based in Hawaii.
Hello?
It had just 3 employees and a single service.
How can we help you?
But what it lacked in size, it made up in personal service and quick response to its customers.
Sure, we can do it.
Today,
right over.
Today, Long Distance USA has grown in size and worldwide capability. And even though its services are now as big as the big guys, there is still only one long-distance company totally committed to the local people.
How's it?
Long Distance USA. Let's talk.
Hello?
A 42-yard field goal by Jason Elam. We were mentioning before the game, he kicked a 62-yarder. This is a 42-yarder, and it could have gone for, boy, 58, 50, maybe even a 60-yarder. That ball kicked up into the tunnel. Rainbows now lead 37-30, and they will kick off to a very potent Fresno State offense. Diggle and Rivers deep, coming up to take it on the 9-yard line is Rivers, and he can run. He's at the 20. Look out, 30, 40, 45-yard line of the Rainbows, all the way down to the 43-yard line of the Rainbow. So you talk about turnabout is fair play. You talk about going deep into the playbook to put on a return. That was an example of it right there. And field position is very well indeed right now for Fresno State.
Well, Fresno runs 2 wedges, one up in the front and then one in the back. And there you see some pretty good blocking, but Matthew Harding able to stop Rivers from going forward. He's forced to make a cutback, and then his teammates able to come back and make the tackle.
49-yard return, first down for Fresno State. The ball at the 43-yard line of the Rainbow. Ball is given on a delay. Up the middle, carrying is Daigle, who's swallowed up by the green shirts. After a short gain, gain of 2, It will be second down and 8, and that is one of the few times in this game that the Rainbows have been able to rise up and finally get to the running back after a very short game.
That's right, Jim. We haven't seen much of that where the running backs of Fresno State just runs up the middle and then goes down. They're always dancing and going for that extra yards. But that time, Hawaii defense rising up to the occasion.
Still for 9 for 14, trying for looking. Can't, being chased out of the pocket by Tanabata, throws it, struck. Intended for Lorenzo Neal. Dilfer was looking to the right side for either Michael Ross on that play or even the tight end Marty Thompson. There was nothing there. He then looked long, and all of a sudden Tanabata flushed him from the pocket. He still had the wherewithal to get the ball to Neal. Neal couldn't hold on. He was thinking about the run after the catch.
Again, Jim, you got to credit that secondary. They're improving a lot in the second half, and as the game goes on, they're looking a lot better. That time, no receivers open. That's why Dilfer had to go for the short pass and look for Neal.
Dilfer 0 for his last 4. Third down and 9 from the Rainbow 43. Dilfer fakes the play action. He wants long. Throws over the middle. It is caught by the tight end, Jeff Arnold, at the 29, and that is enough for a first down. And you talk about a rifle arm. Dilfer just threw that ball. He threw a strike down the middle, threaded the needle. Arnold went up to make the great catch. Well, watch this pass, Jeff.
Then the catch, you got a mismatch there with Darryl Green and Arnold. Arnold standing at 6'5 and Green at 5'10. And if you got a jump ball, I'll put my money on Arnold most of the time.
First down for Fresno State at the Rainbow 30-yard line. Dilfer. Dilfer gives it to Daigle, bounces outside. He's to the 28. Rainbows have him. Lewis Randle. An amazing story tonight on Lewis Randle. Separated shoulder against Utah. Not expected to play tonight. He was doubtful. He comes into the game, and he performs well. Number 51 in green.
Really coming from his inside backer position and making a sure tackle on Fresno State's running back.
Fresno State center Billy Scott, apparently an arm injury. They're helping him to the sideline. Scott will be replaced in there. Billy, 6'4", 265-pound senior from Bartersville, Oklahoma, went to Porterville, California Junior College. He came back from a serious knee injury in 1990. Jason James, number 79. James, 6'5", 305, the sophomore from Fullerton, and at center now for Fresno State. Second down and 10 from the Rainbow 30. Dilfer to throw. Dilfer is hit, gets away, throws long. Sebring batted away. Batted away by Darryl Green.
Well, that time, Shavondi Johnson, 95, from his defensive end position, almost gets a sack here, but Dilfer able to escape it, throw the ball downfield, then Darryl Green making a nice play in batting this ball away.
Remember, Dilfer is 6'5", 225 pounds.
He's not a small guy. He's a hard guy to bring down.
He can stand in there. Big play here, third down and 10. Dilfer chased out of the pocket again. Throws on the run. It is bobbled, caught by Charlie Jones, and they wrestle him out of bounds. Jones, who had an 87-yard punt return. Let's see if it's enough for the first down.
Thank you, short, Jim.
Nope. First down for Fresno State. Carrying the ball all the way to the 16-yard line. So a first down for Fresno State. Angle fooled you, huh, Joe?
I sure did. Referee was in the way.
Here comes Fresno State. Harris to the far side. Let's see if they shift out of this. They do. Sebring comes wide to the right. Dilfer gives the ball. With it is Daigle, and Daigle is hit at the line of scrimmage. Angle's able to string him out to Ase Famui.
Well, Famui makes a nice play there by taking his old lineman, not staying blocked, and then moving to the ball carrier. But Fresno State just overloads the right side with six guys. There you see Farmouy coming in and putting a nice hit there on Anthony Daigle.
Second down and 10 at the 16-yard line. Michael Ross to the far side. To the near side is Harris. Dilfer, three-man pattern. Waits. Now throws to the end zone for Ross. Pushing, shoving, intercepted. Intercepted by Zach Odom.
Beautiful coverage. Delbert decides to go to Michael Ross, but Zach Olin does not get faked by the post corner route. Fake him go inside, then goes out. Zach Olin is right there in good position, makes the interception, brings the ball down. First down for the Rainbows.
Rainbows deny Fresno State. So the Bulldogs march all the way down to the 16-yard line of the Rainbows, and then the interception in the end zone by Zach Odom. Odom's first interception of the season. First down. Michael Carter in trouble. Carter goes down at the 15-yard line. That'll be second down and 15 yards to go.
Yeah, that's definitely a busted assignment by the right side of the offensive line. McGill or Violetti should have got out and got the end man on the line there. He came in scot-free. Nobody blocked him and made the sack.
Zach Ricks credited with the sack. That's his fifth of the season. He now leads Fresno State. And that's a part. Second down, 15 yards to go. Triple wide receiver to the right. Ball is kept by Carter, tries to go up the middle, and they squeeze him to the turf. Short of the 20-yard line, only gets out to the 17. Nick Surface, number 91 there, to make the stop for Fresno State. We have not had a report on Ivan Jasper, whether he was injured or the seriousness of his injury. We don't know yet. Rainbow's third down and 12. Wheat and Branch are flanked to the far side. Carter rolling. Has time. Sideline pattern. It is completed for the first down. All the way out to the 34-yard line.
Wheat.
Johan Wheat.
Yeah.
That's his first reception of the year. Wheat, if you remember last year, waited until the Notre Dame game, the 12th game of the season, to make his first reception. It comes against Fresno State here tonight. That's enough for the first down. So Johan Wheat, 5'10", 170, the sophomore out of Pearl City. They call him Speedy from Tahiti. And now Sam Watson coming to the sideline. Watson taking a hit. Watson, the defensive back, Johnny Johnson, number 25, has gone in to replace him for Fresno State. Johan Wheat, well, he has an international legacy. He is Mr. Nationality on this team. Number 80. Ball is kept by Carter, fumbles the ball, look out. Still loose, Gordon trying for it, picks it up, and Gordon is twirled down inside the 20 at the 17. Fresno State almost had themselves a touchdown because you can pick it up and return it.
That's right, Jim. Almost a big play for Fresno State. Good heads up play here by Brian Gordon and being alerted and seeing that ball. It was actually stripped by number 90, Alfonso Bigelow. But Brian Gordon actually should fall on that ball and not try to pick it up. He'll probably get scoldings from his coaches. He should fall on the ball and not try to pick it up.
6:30 left to play. Second down and 27 for the Rainbows at their own 17. Carter gets swallowed up in the backfield. We have been informed that Ivan Jasper is not injured. He was not injured. He was just taken out of the game. So Michael Carter having his troubles as he gets swallowed up on that play. This is third down and long yardage. Third and 29 for the Rainbow.
Well, Fresno State defensive front really playing well now. They're controlling and containing that option and keeping Michael Carter from getting outside the perimeter.
Rainbow's lead 37-30 in this teeter-totter affair. Carter rolling to the near side, has time, throws up the sidelines. It is almost intercepted by Watson. It was intended for Bleak. We mentioned that Watson left the game. He was out for only one play and then back in.
It's a nice defensive play here by Sam Watson. Sees the ball all the way and goes to the highest point to get the ball.
Charlie Jones is deep. He returned 187 yards for a touchdown in this game in the first half. Elam. Ready for the snap from center. And he loops it out of there. Good hang time. Jones takes it at the 35, gets away from Hardy. He's at the 40. Gets a block. He's at the 45. Ridden down at the 49. So Victor Santa Cruz coming across to get Charlie Jones. When we come back, Fresno State trailing by 7 will have the ball with excellent field position.
You know the attitude. Don't know, don't care, don't bother me.
I don't want to be just another number. It's like they think your time's not important. Some people make you feel this small.
Is anybody listening?
Anybody listening?
At American Savings Bank, we're serious about service.
Celebrate new! Rainbow Chevrolet Geo Pontiac is now Cutter Chevrolet Geo Pontiac. This isn't just a name change. It's an all-new dealership. New name, new management, new look, new super service, and new 1993 models like S10s from $99.88, Astro Vans from $14.988, and all new redesigned Prisms. For new easy financing, call our credit manager today. New finance rates, too, from 2.9% or rebates up to $1,500. Celebrate new today at Cutter Chevrolet Geo Pontiac, 1391 Kapi'olani Boulevard.
You need your brakes fixed, but your car dealer couldn't take you today? What's stopping you? Midas can fix your brakes right the same day you bring in your car. You need brakes, but you're worried about cost? What's stopping you? Right now, get 25% off Midas quality brake shoes or pads. You need brakes? What's stopping you? 25% off Midas brake shoes or pads. Guaranteed for as long as you own your car. Your brakes can't wait. Midas today.
Mentioning Ivan Jasper on the sidelines, and we were told that he is not injured. He did have an ice pack to the back of his neck. So the report is that he could come back into this game. In fact, he is ready to come back in. First down for Fresno State. The ball at the 49-yard line. They trail in this game 37-30. Guilford gives the ball on the delay, and hit by Mika Lee is Ron Rivers.
Well, this is the first game that Lee's been back since the season opener when he hurt his knee. The Samoan hitman is back.
That reception by Johan Voigt, the first pass reception of this game by the Rainbows. Rainbows now have 17 yards in passing. Second down, 8 yards to go for Fresno State at midfield. The ball is fumbled. Rainbows may have it. They do. Mika Lee. That is the second turnover for Fresno State. And Mika Lee coming back from a leg injury.
That's
and coming back into the game at quarterback is Ivan Jasper. Rainbows have 269 yards in total offense. Fresno State 344.
Well, Jim, that was actually a bad pitch. Instead of going to the tailback, it actually hits the lead fullback, the lead blocker, Jamie Christian, in the hip.
First down for the Rainbows at their own 49. Ivan Jasper back in the game at quarterback. He's at the 50. And Jasper lunges forward to the 47. Some extra pushing going on.
Well, notice Hawaii, instead of coming with the straight option, they pull Peter Polly and get him out there on the perimeter to be an extra blocker. And that time, Ivan Jasper able to spring loose for 4 yards.
Gene Smith credited with the tackle. Second down and 6. The ball at the 47-yard line of Fresno State. Ball is given up the middle to Sims. 40, 35. Sims at the 30. Sims chased down, and they get him at the 1. Travis Sims bursting up the middle, stepping into that secondary. 46 yards.
Well, Fresno State so concerned of stopping the perimeter game, they leave the middle wide open. Some nice blocking up the middle, and Travis Sims, his trot all the way to the 1 yard line, almost gets into the end zone.
Wendell Valentine, 6'3", 240, the senior, chased him down, saved the touchdown. They put the ball just inside the two. Travis Sims now 123 yards in this game. That is the fourth time that Sims has gone over the 100-yard mark in five games this season. So the Rainbows now with an opportunity, as into the game replacing Sims is Calvin Melvin. Sims shaken up down by the goal line. Ivan Jasper, the quarterback. Jasper, quarterback, sneak to the one, close to the goal line, but no indication. Now they say yes, touchdown.
Jim, it's strange. I've never seen a goal line defense stand up like the Fresno State defensive line is doing. They are not in their four-point stance, they're in their linebacker stand. And number 66, Oliver, actually helps put Jasper in.
Kind of assisted him with the hit into the end zone. Elomin to try the extra point. It's up, and it is good. Two turnovers for Fresno State have turned into Hawaii scores. One a field goal, one a touchdown. And so the Rainbows now lead 44 to 30 over Fresno State in an action-packed affair.
They see some nice blocking by Kendall Goo. Just taking his number 43 backwards with Jasper right behind.
It was 30 to 27 at halftime. The Rainbows have exploded here in the third period, captivating this crowd with an electrifying 93-yard kickoff return. Check that, 96-yard kickoff return.
Hey, Jim, you know, going back to that goal line play, that's the first time I ever seen a goal line defense stay up in their linebacker stance.
Jim Sweeney on the sidelines for Fresno State. Rivers and Daigle again deep. Rainbows lead in by 14, 44 to 30. At one time, the Rainbows trailed in this game 23 to 8. 3:46 left to play in the third period. Elam kicking off. Waiting for it as Rivers takes it at the one. 20, pumped out of bounds by Joe Shaw.
It was a nice hustle there by Junior Favai, getting downfield and really running right through the wedge to get Rivers to the sideline, and then Joe Shaw pushing Rivers out of bounds. But nice hustle by Junior Favai.
So first down for Fresno State. They put the ball at the 21-yard line. Hawaii was down 30 to 19 in the second quarter and has now scored 25 unanswered points. First down, Sebring against Zach Odom. The ball is given up the middle. Carrying the ball is Rivers, and they get him from behind. Rivers almost stepped into wide open territory. Walter Santiago saved something big.
And that time looked like they're going to the right, and he makes a nice cut back to the left. It's a good thing that Walter Santiago was there to make the tackle, because he could have gone all the way.
Excellent gain on the play. Second down and 2.5 for Fresno State. The ball at their own 29-yard line. Rainbows lead 44 to 30. Ball is pitched to Rivers, trying to get outside. Rainbows have him. Rivers still up, and now he's down.
And you can give the credit to number 25, Demetrius Henderson, for coming up from his quarterback position. Let's take a look at number 25 playing quarterback. He is a true freshman. There you see, beats the block by number one. He comes in and makes the initial hit on Rivers, and then the rest of the Rainbows able to come in and make the tackle. But nice play there by Demetrius Henderson, the true freshman.
Got by the block from number one, Michael Ross. Third down and 11. Sebrin and Charlie Jones are the wide receivers. Back to pass, Dilfer. Dilfer hit as he throws, and down it goes. They say Rainbow's won intentional grounding. Now the penalty flag goes up in the air. Dilfer can't believe it. Off comes the helmet. Intentional grounding, loss of down.
And good call. There's nobody who's an eligible receiver was around the area. Ali Pule had a chance at him, and Faumui also there. But as you can see, number 20 is the only eligible receiver, but he's like 15, 20 yards downfield. Not even close to the ball.
So that will bring up fourth down, and Derek Mahoney will have to kick the ball out of the end zone for Fresno State. 2:14 left to play in the third period. It has been wild here at Aloha. Derek Branch standing at the Fresno State 45-yard line. Rainbows have 10 men on the line of scrimmage. Very short kick. Branch comes up, takes it at the 35-yard line to the 30, and gets to the 26 before they wedge him to the turf. So an excellent opportunity now for the Rainbows with 2:05 left to play here in the third quarter.
Nice.
And the Rainbows with excellent field position, Joe.
Nice return there by Derek Branch. Gutsy. I mean, he can feel and see the defender coming downfield to hit him while he's trying to catch the ball. But instead of making a fair catch, he decides to take the ball and takes the ball upfield and gets the ball on the 26-yard line.
Rainbows have completed only one pass, that a 17-yarder to Johan Voigt. It was Voigt's first reception of the year. Ivan Jasper gives the ball up the middle to Sims. Sims, the line of scrimmage, the 26. Sims to the 24, second down and 8. Sims now 17 carries, 125 yards in this game.
Here we get to take a look at Travis Sims' legs. It's one of the most amazing scenes you ever see. The guy's got some huge calf muscles.
Second down and 8. The ball at the Fresno State 24. Rainbows lead 44-30. Audibilizing at the line of scrimmage is Jasper. Jasper gives the ball up the middle. Jasper may not have wanted to give Sims the ball that time.
Yeah, I think Travis just grabbed the ball and wanted to take it himself.
1:17 left to play in the third period.
You'll be able to see the measure with Sims and Jasper. They can see Jasper wanted to continue on down the line with the ball, but as he was going down the line, he didn't have the ball.
Triple wide receiver to the right. Grant sets up on the left. Jasper gets nailed by Oliver.
Nice play.
Earl Oliver almost coming in from the sky that time on Jasper.
Well, he runs around. Well, Oliver runs around Peter Polley's block. What Peter needs to do is, if he's high like that, and he needs to cut block Oliver to give Jasper a chance.
46-yard field goal attempt now by Elam. It is up on its way. Hits the upright. It is not good. So Fresno State holds off the rainbow attempt. 23 seconds left. What are the odds of that? And you see it. You do see it on the upright.
I'm sure Jason Elam is very disappointed in that, because that's usually a chip shot for him.
Elam, when they moved the uprights closer together last season, said, you know what they're going to have us do in about 5 years? They're going to just have one upright and ask us to hit it.
That's right.
Well, he does hit that one. Fresno State first down at their own 28-yard line. In motion comes Sebrin. Dilfer looking for man pattern, throws over the middle. It is incomplete. Not able to hold on. Ron Rivers got his fingers around the ball but did not have possession before the ball hit the turf. 18 seconds left in period number three. Rainbows have scored 17 unanswered points. Go ahead, Joe.
Dilfer had to rush that pass because Tase Famui, again in the backfield. I mean, Famui is just running over these Fresno State offensive linemen. I mean, he is just too strong and too quick for these guys. And that time, Dilfer rushing his pass because of Famui.
Dilfer now 11 for 20, 169 yards. He's been intercepted once. Lorenzo Neal, single setback. It is Neal on a delay. Hit by Famui and Ma'avasa. Ma'avasa and Famui.
Well, both guys just come knifing in. But watch Famui. Takes his man back, takes another blocker, and goes to make the tackle. And Ma'avasa also there. But beautiful play by Famui, taking on two blockers.
So Ma'avasa and Tase Famui double teaming that time. Third quarter has come to an end, and the Rainbows now lead 44 to 30 with one to play.
Okay, so these guys may know a little more than we do about Bud.
It's the rice.
It's the hops.
It's the rice.
But of course, we know a lot about other things.
Hi, can I buy you something to drink? Yeah, like maybe a light beer? Or maybe he's like a Bud.
Someday, boy, you're gonna learn from your mistakes.
Harry, we're right here. We need the cash.
Look, Ma, I can't go in there.
Let's go. Nobody's gonna see you.
Hey, look who's here.
Now you will find convenient Banco bank machines in Foodland, Times, Safeway, and KTA supermarkets.
Hey, Dad, and what are you doing here?
What are you doing here?
It's mine.
It's great to be your super convenient bank. Bank of Hawaii, Hawaii's bank.
Making it to the pros takes a certain level of excellence. The experience to get the job done right and a reputation for quality. Having what you need on hand, putting the parts together. For the best possible performance. Being in the pros takes a special brand of confidence. And for professionally trained technicians, that confidence is CarQuest. CarQuest. Welcome to the pros.
On the next Street Justice.
1 Henry 17, where's the backup?
Okay, sports fans, what do we got?
Now, who the hell are you?
Boudreau gets a new partner.
Craigie!
Look at the bright side. We caught a serial killer.
With an unusual style.
I thought we'd play a little game.
He's gonna blow our case with this guy.
Hoffman, don't.
Get me out of here, this guy's psycho!
Back off, Sarge, I mean it!
Street Justice, Monday night at 7 on Hawaii's very own KHNL 13. This KHNL sports presentation is sponsored by Bud Light. Everything else is just a light.
Now you see Trent Dilfer's passing statistics, 169 yards, no touchdowns, one interception. Fresno has only four first downs in the last two quarters. We begin quarter number four, Rainbows leading 44 to 30. Dilfer, wide receivers, left and right. Dilfer, quick pattern, complete to Sebrin, breaks a tackle. Sebrin at the 30, and the Rainbows hit him at the 31. Turned out to be a short game, the line of scrimmage being the 26 out to the 31. And that will bring up fourth down and 7.5. Fresno State will kick it away here in the opening moments of the fourth quarter. Derek Mahoney is deep, will punt, and deep for the Rainbows is Derek Branch. Branch, no fair catch, he will return it, takes it at the 30. 35, Branch goes out of bounds as he runs out of room. So he went out at the 34. So the Rainbows will put the ball in play at the 34-yard line. We're in the fourth quarter, 14 minutes and 14 seconds left. Rainbows trailed 23-8, 30-19. Incredibly, they have come back with a 17-point third quarter to lead 44-30. Fresno State took the opening kickoff of this game, and you would think that it was a clinic. Rainbows responded, running the option. Ivan Jasper and Michael Carter have shared quarterback duties. It is Jasper in there now at the start of the fourth quarter. First and 10. J- Jasper gives the ball, carrying the ball up the middle. Travis Sims. Sims all the way out to the 44-yard line. Sims having himself a day.
Hawaii going with the counter option trap. To make like, you see Ivan turning around to give the ball to Travis Sims, and wide open. There's a big hole there for Travis Sims to run up. But a different look of the option play and the trap play by Ivan Jasper by turning around.
Smith and Johnson made the stop. Ball again is given to Sims. Sims knifes into the secondary on second and one. That's enough for the first down. Carries all the way out to the 49-yard line. Western Athletic Conference, San Diego State over to UTEP. And a big surprise, New Mexico over previously unbeaten Utah in conference play. There you see Colorado State over Air Force. First down, Jasper runs it into Fresno State territory, runs it to the 48-yard line. Chris Rockwell, number 98, made the stop. He's from Oroville, California. And Brad Bell. And BYU holding off Wyoming, 31-28. BYU is behind in that game, 21-7. Branch and Boyd to the far side. Ball again is given to Travis Sims. Sims to the 44. That will bring up third down about three.
But some power running by Sims, but some nice blocking up front by Amosa, Peter Polly, and Kelly McGill, really driving the white jerseys backwards and changing the line of scrimmage. And that's the goal of all the offensive line, is to change the line of scrimmage, meaning to push those defenders backwards, and that's what they did on that last play.
Third down three. Sims again. Sims short of the first down. That will bring up fourth down. 12 minutes and 14 seconds left. What the Rainbows, and you only can say this because of precedent, what the Rainbows cannot do is start the play trying not to lose instead of to win. Once you start playing trying not to lose, bad things happen to this ball club.
Well, that time I thought they would try to get out to the perimeter, but Jasper decided to give the ball to Travis Sims up the middle.
Tommy Jones deep for Fresno State. Elam will punch it high. Ball comes down at the 20, takes a rainbow bounce. Now Fresno State bounce out to the 22. And it will be first down for the Bulldogs. Sims now 20 carries, 145 yards in this game. 20-yard punt by Elam, who wanted to position the ball. And so Fresno State, all of a sudden the wheels have come off on this very potent offense for Fresno State. They find themselves behind by 14, 44-40. But again, we mentioned much time left in this game, and they certainly have the potential. Charlie Jones and Malcolm Sebrin, wide receiver, Gilbert to throw long. He wants Jones out in front. Can't hold on, and we'll have interference. Interference on Zach Odom.
Now, I think if Zach was to see the replay of that last play, he would just let that ball go and let that play die out instead of trying to trip up the receiver. If this ball was not catchable, there's no way he would have got the ball. And what Zach Odom is doing is he's conceding that he got beat, and he'll take the interference penalty instead of having the receiver score a touchdown. But that time, there's no way that receiver would have caught the ball.
So a 15-yard penalty, automatic first down. That moves the ball out over the 35. They put it at the 38-yard line. First down for Fresno State. 11:25 left to play in the game. Fresno State down by 14, 44-30. Jones and Sebrin, again the wide receivers, again Dilfer to throw. Three-man pattern, throws it long up the sideline. He wants Jones again against Odom. It is almost picked off by Jones on the back of Odom, but he couldn't hold on, and it will go as an incomplete pass.
Well, that time Zach Odom said, "You ain't gonna beat me again." And so he gets in good position here to try to make the interception. And number 24 actually runs him over.
Do the ball come down? There you see the push. But it will go as an incomplete pass. Second down. And 10 yards to go. The ball at the 38-yard line. Dilfer again to throw. Three-man pattern. Looks over the middle. Checks off. Comes to the near side. Now throws it. It is incomplete. Interference again will be called. This time it's on Odom as he hit Michael Ross.
Well, that was not a smart play at all by Odom. Because you had Odom had two of his teammates in good position to bat the ball away to try to make the interception. You see Lou Randle in the area. And you see Odom coming across the field. He's really not making a smart play there.
That's two interference calls on Zach Odom. And that has given Fresno State outstanding field position. They are now at the 47-yard line of the Rainbows. And are they picking on Zach Odom?
I think they are, Jim.
Oh, yes.
Well, Zach's a competitor.
Here comes Fresno State. Dilfer again to throw. Chased out of the pocket by Tanevasa. Dilfer breaks a tackle, gets to the 40-yard line. Not short of the first down. Dilfer gets up limping a bit, but he'll stay in the game.
Darrell Green coming up from his strong safety position to make the tackle on Dilfer. But again, credit that Hawaii secondary on that play for good coverage.
Second down, 3.5. Ball at the Rainbow 40. Dilfer gives the ball around the side to Rivers. Rivers only gets back to the line of scrimmage.
Well, Darrell Green comes in and makes the play, but the guy that really created that play was number 12, Walter Santiago. Really making a nice play coming from his inside linebacker position, scraping down the line of scrimmage and coming up to make the initial hit right there.
So third down and two for Fresno State. The ball just outside the 39-yard line of the Rainbow. Sebring and Harris are the wide receivers. And Tanevasa may have made contact. And that will be offside.
Dead ball. Offside on the defense. 5-yard penalty.
That's very uncharacteristic of Ma Tanevasa. He's a very smart player. You won't see him jump offside like that many times.
Third time that Fresno State has been able to get a first down by virtue of a penalty.
Now watch Dilfer. Does he draw him offside? No. I think Ma just didn't concentrate on that last play.
First and 10 from the Rainbow 34. Slant pattern intended for Michael Ross. Drawn wide, incomplete, second down and 10. 9:25 left to play in the game. Rainbows lead by a score of 44-30. It has been a wide open affair. This has been more than a tag team match.
It really has.
So second and 10 for Fresno State. The ball just outside the 34-yard line. Charlie Jones flanks to the far side. To the near side is Michael Ross, and Sebring is slotted inside of Jones. Second down, Dilfer looking, throws. It is thrown high, incomplete. It was intended for Charlie Jones. Wide open down the middle with Sebring.
Well, the last two passes, Dilfer has been off.
Boy, Sebring was in a pasture down about the 10-yard line. Nobody around him.
Well, you see Sebring wide open there. But Dilfer decided to go the other way.
Third down for Fresno State. Third down and 10. Ross to the right, Jones to the left. Dilfer fakes the play action. Looking. dancing, still up, still looking, now throws for the end zone, some bumping, caught! Oh, what a catch! Touchdown, Michael Roth! That is the catch of the game! What a catch by Michael Roth! A leaping catch in the end zone! Dilfer chased out of the pocket, still had the wherewithal to find Ross in that crowd, and Ross with a leaping grab beats two Rainbows.
He's right over Addison and Odom.
So the crowd buzzing here at Aloha Stadium about that catch. What a reception by Michael Ross. That's his third touchdown reception of the season. Mahoney comes in and drills the extra point. It is now 44-37, Rainbows, and still much time left.
Hey, I'm vain. Of course I'm vain. That's why I comb my hair the way I do. I dress the way I do. That's why I stay in shape.
To compete against men half your age takes a certain kind of power.
That's why I play like an animal.
The power of Power Stick.
I give it everything I have every time I walk out there.
50% more wetness and odor fighters for stroke.
This works best for me. I don't want people going around saying, whew, that Connors, he's tough to be around.
Power Stick by Fabergé. Power that won't let you down.
I told you I was vain.
Drop everything. Dodge B250 Ram vans now come complete with everything you need for work or play. Like air, bigger tires and mirrors, power everything, and tons more. You'll get $1,000 cash back, up to $2,720 in package discounts, and save $3,720 in all during the National Dodge Truck Sale.
Now available at your Hawaii Dodge dealer.
Amazing but true. Right now, you can get two tempting Big Mac sandwiches for just $3 at your Hawaii McDonald's.
What you want is what you get at McDonald's today.
Of course, they won't be spinning around like this. As good as this Egg McMuffin looks, we thought we'd skip ahead to the important part. Right now, your Hawaii McDonald's has two Egg McMuffin sandwiches at breakfast for just $3.
This KHNL sports presentation is sponsored in part by Surf Laundry Detergent and by Power Stick Deodorant and Antiperspirant.
You can credit three errors in the offense. First of all, the offensive line for the time. And then secondly, all of Dilfer for the pass here and just the poise to find a receiver. Then number one, Michael Ross for making a sensational catch over two Rainbows.
Amazing catch, 34-yard touchdown pass.
Michael Ross out of Carson High School, a junior.
So Dilfer with his 13th touchdown pass of the season. Mahoney kicks off. It's a squibber, a floater that comes off to the side. The Rainbows will have excellent field position on the 35-yard line. 9:07 left. Now the Rainbows cannot sit on, they had a 14-point lead moments ago, 34-yard touchdown pass from Dilfer to Ross has cut that lead in half. So the Rainbows cannot play patty cake football here. They cannot sit on this lead and get into that mode of trying not to lose instead of trying to win. Many teams do this. But when the Rainbows get too conservative, bad things happen. We see that Travis Sims is not in the lineup. Calvin Melvin is. He's from Wahiawalelehua High School. Ball is kept and with it with a short game from the 35 to the 37 is Ivan Jasper. Jasper out of Los Angeles went to Jordan High School in Los Angeles with the student body president of Jordan High School before coming to the University of Hawaii. Chris Rockwell there to make the stop for Fresno State. Jasper, one of the outstanding quarterbacks in the country. The Rainbows very, very happy to get his quality here on the Manoa campus. Second down and 8. Jasper gives it on the reverse. In trouble is Derek Branch, and he's all the way back to the 26-yard line. Gene Smith would have none of it. Smith, a redshirt freshman, 6'4", 210.
Well, he's a big guy. He was originally recruited to play tight end. Then they moved him over to defensive end because of he's just a lanky guy. They see he reached the reverse all the way.
Now the Rainbows have completed only one pass in this game. One, a 17-yarder to Johan Voigt. Here come the Rainbows to the line. Third down, 18 yards to go. They're all the way back at their 27-yard line. Branch and Voigt to the far side. So the workhorse for the Rainbows not in there now. Jasper Rowland stretching the defense. Throws long. And it is incomplete. Threw it out of bounds. That will be fourth down. We have a penalty flag. Wonder if we have roughing the passer. Jack Baker says, personal foul, roughing the passer.
And I think it's number 49, or 99, or 98, Chris Rockwell. Oh.
So roughing the passer after the pass has been thrown.
Well, Jasper takes some punishment there.
Your car is your star player to help keep it performing its best in your weekly running
foul,
game.
Roughing the passer on the defense, 15 yards, first down.
That's an automatic first down. The Rainbows had 18 yards to go on third down. Roughing the passer, personal foul, that's an automatic first down.
That was not a nice or smart play there by 98 Chris Rockwell and 49 Wendell Valentine.
Well, that takes Jasper right out of the game because Michael Carter comes back in. Carter on first down. Melvin is the fullback. Carter just gets swallowed up. So the Rainbows are without Jasper, the most effective quarterback of the night for the Rainbows. As far as yardage is concerned, they are without Travis Sims. He apparently has been injured and is not in the game. And so they're trying to hold on here with 7:19 left. Now Sims comes back in.
Earl Oliver, number 66, makes a nice play here. He crashes in. Instead of taking a fullback, he takes Michael Carter down with him, and making a nice decision there to go with Carter instead of the fullback.
Sims, big hole, 50, Sims at the 45, Sims to the 40. And you could see that coming. You could see that coming because Fresno State had overloaded everybody to the far side. And it was wide open for Sims. All he had to do was get that small hole, and it opened up.
Jim, the thing is, they line up their linebackers up on the line, and there's actually no linebackers, nobody to play the middle area. So if the fullback can get right past the line of scrimmage, there's a lot of room.
18-yard gain. Tack on 18 more yards for Travis Sims. Record tonight. He's at 163. First and 10 from the Fresno State 40. Carter turns. Fakes, no, gives it to Melvin. And Melvin stumbles into the secondary, keeps his feet, gets all the way to, let's see where they give him forward progress. They're going to say the 35, you know, the play of almost 6 yards. Your car is your star player to help keep it performing its best in your weekly running game. Try high-quality Chevron gasoline with the cleansing power of Equilor. Chevron, simply smarter. Rainbows moving the ball. They're also going along with the clock. Clock ticking, 6 minutes, 8 seconds left. Rainbows at the line, second down and four. Ball again is given to Sims. Sims finds the hole, close to the first down. Able to power his way to the 31-yard line. So that will bring up third down for the Rainbows. Third and one. Brad Bell there making the stop for the white shirts. Bell out of Fresno, California. Went to Clovis West High School. Very competitive. In fact, he really likes volleyball. He says volleyball is a kind sport that takes his mind off of everything. Third down and one. Quarterback sneak, Carter, first down Rainbows. They keep the ball and they keep the clock ticking. 5:25 left to play. Rainbows lead by a score of 44-37. You had to bring your abacus to this game, that's for sure.
Well, what Fresno State is doing is they're bringing their backers up on the line. And it looks like there's seven defensive linemen, and Hawaii's offensive line are treating them as such. And like I said, if you can get past that defensive front, there's nobody there to really play a linebacker.
And credit Michael Carter, playing hurt, but running this offense. He has been in and out of this game. Carter fakes, nope, gives the ball to Sims. Sims just power runs the ball to the 27. That'll bring up second down. This is Woody Hayes, Ohio State football. It's almost, we all hearken back to the 3 yards and a cloud of dust, but on the astroturf, you're not going to get that. Sims goes to the sideline, and Calvin Melvin will come in to replace him. Rainbows have been unable to move the ball, really, without Sims in there. Rainbows are not going to pass the ball. I believe Fresno State says they're going to run it. Again, Fresno State with the linebackers up on the line. Ball is kept by Carter. Pitches back. Bad pitch. And Marlo Lewis picks it up on the sideline and carries the ball to the 24-yard line of Fresno State. Marlo Lewis, boy, talk about, he's almost like a shortstop trying to get, prevent a base hit from going up the middle into center field. He has to try to corral that waddling football.
But Michael Carter tried to pitch the ball in the last second. Actually, the ball actually goes forward.
Well, Travis Sims, 24 carries, 170 yards, one touchdown. This is the best night that Sims has had as a Rainbow, and he is back in there. This is his career best. Third down and five. See if it goes to Sims again. It does. Sims to the 20. Sims to the 19. So that's another 6 yards. That's 176 yards. And there's 4 minutes and 13 seconds left to play. And the Rainbows just out-muscling Fresno State now up front. Zach Ricks made the stop along with Chris Peters. Ricks the nose guard and Peters the inside linebacker. They are going to measure for the first down.
Well, Sims will come right at you on this play. You'll see the slight hole there. And he's able to get through to get the first down. Some nice blocking up front by Pauly Amosa and Kelly McGill.
If this game were a test of character, it would be a final exam. 4:07 left. Clock still ticking. Rainbows holding on. 44-37. They have the ball inside the 20-yard line. These are the toughest yards on the field. It is Sims. Sims falling forward to the 17, gain of three. That'll bring up second down and 7 yards to go.
Well, Hawaii going with the fullback play on the last couple of plays. It looks rather conservative, but what it's also doing is killing the clock.
And it is having Fresno State look inside and perhaps soften up on the perimeter. We'll see. 3:24 left. Rainbows are in no hurry. They have 7 seconds in which to snap the ball. Again, it is Sims. Sims to the 15. Sims behind the blocking of Lenny Amosa, Peter Pauly, Doug Violetti, Kelly McGill, Travis Fonseca.
And it comes down to the offensive line and defensive battle here. I mean, watch the battle up front. There you can see some of the Fresno State defensive players knifing their way through some blocks. But in the middle with Lenny Amosa, you can see him driving his man backwards.
Third down, five. Big play here for the Rainbow. Carter gives the ball to Sims, and that's one too often. That'll bring a fourth down. We will see Jason Elam, 2 minutes, 32 seconds left. This should be a chip shot for Jason Elam. He has missed one tonight. We mentioned that Elam hit a 62-yard field goal here at Aloha Stadium before the start of this game.
The fans here was hoping that Michael Carter would have pulled the ball out of Sims' hands and take the ball down the perimeter with a two-way option. But that doesn't happen.
Rainbows only have 7 seconds in which to snap the ball. They may be going to take a delay of game penalty here, and they do. Now the Rainbows call a timeout. So somebody called a timeout before the clock ran out. And we shall return. 1:58 left to play. Rainbows holding on.
He really does take deep down beliefs and his vision of what's best for the people of Hawaii and carry them out. He doesn't look for a quick soundbite or a big political fanfare. It's easy to read headlines and it's easy for people to throw out a lot of phrases and slogans, but to actually deliver and do what we need without making a big political show of it is something that's rare, and that's what the senator does. Behind the scenes, he's keeping us alive.
It's comforting to know that night after night, year after year, we're out there, shining bright. Unocal 76, where you find people who care about cars.
JCPenney has comforting news for you. Lazy Boy recliners in a wide array of colors and styles are waiting just for you at JCPenney's furniture department. Kick back and relax in a world-famous Lazy Boy, featuring adjustable footrest and reclining back. Durable fabrics ensure years of lasting beauty. Reward yourself today with a Lazy Boy from JCPenney's furniture department. So rush on in and relax.
So the outcome of this game with 1 minute and 58 seconds may come down to this. Things happen, but Jason Elam, 32-yard attempt, straight on. One for one in the game. In field goals, it is down, it is kicked, and it is good. So Jason Elam may have put the seal on this victory for the Rainbows. May have. 1:54 left. 47-37, Hawaii.
This sandwich is a real eye-opener. A chicken breast, crispy on the outside, marinated so it's spicy on the inside. It's the new Spicy Crispy Chicken Sandwich at Jack in the Box.
Spicy.
At most places, you can get a bite to eat for under a dollar. Trouble is, all you get is a bite. But at Jack in the Box, 99 cents gets you a delicious double cheeseburger. It's more than a bite, it's a banquet.
It's the most innovative and exciting lineup in our history. Introducing Jeep and Eagle for 1993. See the technically advanced new Jeep Grand Cherokee and the sophisticated new Eagle Vision. Get a Cherokee Sport for less than you ever dreamed possible. Or jump into fun-loving Jeep Wrangler at a price like this. But whatever you do, don't miss the 93 at your Jeep and Eagle dealer today.
Going on now, only at your Hawaii Jeep and Eagle dealers.
When I jump around, that's good. When your camcorder jumps around, so does the picture, and that's bad. But this Panasonic Palmcorder camcorder has digital image stabilization. Okay, switch it on. See? It holds the picture steady, even if your hand jumps around this much. And unlike the other compact camcorder format, the Panasonic Palmcorder is VHS. So its taste can play in your VHS recorder and everyone else's. The Panasonic Palmcorder. Yes, it's VHS.
Rainbow's leading now by 10. 47-37. After leading 23-8 at the end of the first quarter, Fresno State has been outscored 39-14 by the Rainbows. Elam kicks off. It is a short kick. And it is taken on the 15-yard line by Jamie Christian. Christian up across the 30 and is twirled to the turf at the 34. It will be first down there for Fresno State. 1:47 left. Now Fresno State definitely has the receivers and the passer in Dilfer. In passing, Jasper is 0 for 4. Carter 1 for 5 for 17 yards. The Rainbows have completed just one pass, and that was to Johan Voigt. Here comes Fresno State. Sebrin picked up by Zach Odom on the near side. Sebrin looking, goes long. It is caught by Jones, spins away. Rainbow chase him. And down he goes at the Rainbow 29-yard line. Charlie Jones.
Charlie Jones, he's the star guy. He's the guy that made that long kickoff return. He makes a nice play here.
36 yards, 1:38 left. Much time left in this game. And you have an offense that has the potential of Fresno State. Dilfer, three-man pattern, four-man pattern. Dilfer throws on the run. It is complete to the tight end, Marty Thompson. Thompson from Mammoth Lakes, California, went to Mammoth High School. That's his eighth reception of the year. And that is his 57th career reception. And he was a walk-on to Fresno State. Second down and four, 107-106. Left clock still ticking. Automatizing is Dilfer. Dilfer back to pass. He may run. He will. He's at the 15. And gives ground. 10. 5-yard line. And they say he went out at the 4. 44 seconds left. Darryl Green chased him out.
Well, that was just a nice play by Dilfer. Really showing some speed on that play. You see him calling the timeout. But Dilfer doesn't see any of his receivers open, so decided to take the ball himself. And he does some nice running here, outrunning some of the Hawaii defenders. Then Darryl Green able to catch him up. And finally bring him down on the 4-yard line.
Darryl Green doesn't get him. He is in. We'll be back. 44 seconds left.
Gas Express means convenient. 28 locations. On Oahu, Maui, and the Big Island, there's a Gas Express near you. Gas Express convenience. Open round the clock. Fast, friendly service. Easy one-stop shopping. Gas Express convenience for Hawaii's drivers. Convenience you can count on 24 hours a day.
It's pretty simple. Hawaiian is on time.
On time departure, flight 316.
I've been flying for Hawaiian for 21 years, and I know we're on time.
If you show up late for the flight nowadays, you've missed it.
I know Hawaiian flies on time because I look at the stats.
I fly to Maui, Lihue, and Kona, and all my flights are on time.
I've been here for 23 years, and I can tell you, it's never been better.
Hawaiian Airlines, on-time departure.
Hawaiian guarantees on-time performance.
And we're proud of it.
Did you ever wonder about using a computer or want to know how to read blueprints? Would you like to learn sign language or finish up your high school diploma? You can do all this and more with one phone call to the Adult Education Office. Most courses are free or at very low cost. All are open to you, if you still wonder. A message in the public interest from the Hawaii Carpenters Union.
There'll be a better Hawaii for folks like you and me.
It is first and goal to go for Fresno State. They trail in this game 47-37. Quickly, they're to the line. This is that heavy T formation. And being cut down is Lorenzo Neal.
Shaw.
Joe Shaw, number 8, came in to get him. Shaw, out of Seattle, Washington, went to John F. Kennedy High School. Quickly, with 29 seconds left, Fresno State back in that heavy T formation. Ball is given on a sweep to the near side. With it is Daigle. He gets to the 1. Fumbles the ball, but he was already on the ground. 17, 16, 15 seconds left. 14, and now they stop the clock with 13 seconds left. Fresno State calls a timeout. And it will be third down, goal to go. The ball just outside the 1-yard line.
Well, Jim, Fresno State gets in that big T formation, gives the ball to the furthest guy to the right, Daigle, and he's able to find a hole on the inside. He cuts back and gets the ball within the 2-yard line.
Dilfer in this game has rushed 7 times for 39 yards. He has passed for 250 yards and 1 touchdown. He is 15 for 29 in passing.
Then one thing to remember.
Go ahead, Joe.
One thing to remember is the Bulldogs have bounced back with victories following each of their first 2 losses this season. And since 1985, during which time Fresno State has compiled a best in the West record of 68-17-2, the Bulldogs have posted a mark of 14-1-1 in games that have followed losses. So Fresno State University has not suffered back-to-back losses since the 1987 season, and that's very impressive.
That is. Also, they come in with an incredible statistic when they're in the red zone or the go zone inside the 20. Through 6 games, the Bulldogs have come away with 24 touchdowns and 5 field goals. And they average, once they get inside the 20, 96%. They will score once they get inside the 20-yard line. In fact, in the last 3 games, Fresno State has converted 13 out of 13 drives that have entered the red zone. That's coming into the game tonight. And tonight, they have run all over this field.
Well, if you think the referees are giving Fresno State a longer timeout, no, Hawaii also called a timeout.
So Fresno State with 13 seconds left. will try to punch it into the end zone and then no doubt go for the onside kick. They trail by 10, 47 to 37, 13 seconds left. Here comes Fresno State. And we have another timeout.
Well, interesting strategy here by Hawaii coaches to call a back-to-back timeout.
Clock will not move no matter how many timeouts you call. Still 13 seconds left.
Now, I think there was some confusion between Smeelin and Wagner.
Fresno State has it third down, the ball just outside the 1 yard line. They know that will come out in that what they call the heavy T formation. And they run many things off that heavy T formation.
Well, Jim, you got to credit defensive coordinator Jeff Smeelin there walking aside Bob Wagner for making a lot of adjustments during halftime.
Now here's the question. I mean, you're a yard away. You're up against a defensive line that has played very well, especially in the second half. Do you throw the ball to get it into the end zone, knowing that if it is incomplete, that will stop the clock? You still have another down in which to do it. We'll see. They run it, diving into the end zone and scoring is Daigle. That's his second rushing touchdown. And so Daigle goes into the end zone. It is now 47 to 43. And we'll see whether Fresno State will go for 2 points.
Well, if Hawaii did their homework, they should know that every time they get close to the end zone, they're going to give it to number two, Daigle. They see some athletic ability getting over the pile and into the end zone.
They pitch it to Rivers. Will he throw it? He will. It's up for grabs. It is incomplete. And we may have interference. It was intended for the tight end, Marty Thompson. Covering on the play was Demetrius Henderson.
Pass interference on the defense. Half the distance to the goal.
Well, the tight end was wide open, so Demetrius was trying to gain some ground on him and trying to do the ball thrown short, and Demetrius didn't realize that, so he gets called for the INT.
Fresno State needs this 2-point conversion. They can come back with an onside kick, and if they are able to recover that kick, long field goal, a miracle field goal, if you will give them the victory. Stranger things have happened, especially in this conference. Half the distance to the goal, here they come again.
Huge play.
This time it goes to Neal, and he gets the 2-point conversion. So it is now 49 to 47, Rainbows, with 10 seconds left, and you know it'll be an onside kick. But excuse me, 47-45, 47-45. That's the score. Scoreboard was driving me crazy.
Well, Hawaii showing some weakness in their goal line front. Two plays in a row, the Fresno State offense just goes right over them, right over the tackle.
So it is 47 for the Rainbows, 45 for Fresno State. That is the score with 10 seconds left. And the scoreboard now confirms that, 47 to 45. Now the Rainbows will have their all-hands team up there. All the Rainbows have to do here is recover this onside kick, but you go back to the Notre Dame game that took place here at Aloha Stadium last year, where the Rainbows were successful in two onside kicks. And they finally lost that game to the Irish by only one touchdown. Here it comes. Mahoney kicks it. There's the bounce. It is caught by the Rainbow.
Danny Glover.
Rodney Glover, the quarterback.
Danny Glover. Excuse me. That's his uncle.
That's his uncle.
Lethal Weapon 3. Well, great play by Rodney. Rodney Glover.
Or Lethal Weapon 2. Or Lethal Weapon 1. So the onside kick does not work. The Rainbows come up with it. All they have to do is take the snap here. Rainbows lead 47-45. I apologize for the confusion in the scores, but it is 47-45. Been a lot of scoring. Ivan Jasper takes the snap, and this game is over. Kelly McGill shoves after the whistle. Some extra pushing going on, but that is it. The game is over, and the Rainbows come from behind, and then they have to hold off a very determined Fresno State team to win it by a score of 47-45. So Jim Sweeney comes across the field, and he will shake hands with Bob Wagner and the Rainbow team. Sweeney very gracious in defeat, as he always is. There you see Bob Wagner is just swinging his face. Boy, we had a game, didn't we? That was a game. People will drag themselves out of here tonight. This crowd is emotionally spent. We will return for the final again. Rainbows lead, or Rainbows win it, 47-45.
Two on two, Jam City, and I'm the mayor.
Yo, fella, how about a game of hoops?
Hey, what? With you?
No, with your mama.
Mom?
This guy was good, but he was all dribble.
Say what?
Come on, man.
Man, he deserved one of these.
Franchise, on the court, bud.
Solid.
24,000, 36,000, 48,000 a year. Where is everybody?
At the copier. Which is why Ricoh created a super efficient copier that automatically feeds, copies, sorts, covers, and staples reports for about $15 a day. So your employees can get back to work on the things you hired them to do, like putting your company on top.
Demand quality. Invest in superior Ricoh copier systems.
D-I-O.
And away we go.
Reserve your Las Vegas package at special low prices to downtown's exciting Four Queens Hotel, or the dazzling Golden Nugget, or the new oasis on the Strip, the elegant Mirage Hotel. Fly in American Airlines with hotels, transfers, and some meals. Plus, save $60 with free stopovers in Los Angeles and San Francisco. Call now for the special to Las Vegas.
If you're an armchair quarterback, Channel 13's Bob Wagner Show is made to order. This year, the show is live, and you can telephone Coach Wagner from the comfort of your living room. We'll still have exciting highlights and in-depth player interviews. But if you have a burning question about Saturday's game, such as...
Do you have a quarterback controversy now? Do you have three quarterbacks now?
I don't perceive any problems at this point.
Catch the Bob Wagner Show live Sunday night at 10:05 on KHNL Channel 13. Tonight, GTE Hawaiian Tell players who went beyond the call. Trent Dilfer, the sophomore quarterback from Fresno State. And Dilfer carried the ball 9 times for 39 yards. He passed 15 out of 29, 250 yards, and 1 touchdown. Dilfer is our player of the game from Fresno State. And for the University of Hawaii, a career high. Travis Sims, 28 carries, 180 yards, 1 touchdown. Rainbows hold off Fresno State by a score of 47-45. GTE Hawaiian Tell is pleased to make a contribution for scholarships at the University of Hawaii. GTE Hawaiian Tell, beyond the call. An amazing game. An amazing game from the start to the finish. And it wasn't over. Even after the game was over, you weren't sure that that really was going to be the final score. But Hawaii is now 4-1 on the season. They are 3-1 in the Western Athletic Conference. Fresno State is now 3-4 on the season, and they are 1-2 in the WAC. So a great game tonight at Aloha Stadium. We hope that you have enjoyed it as the Rainbows come from behind. And then they have to really hold on to beat Fresno State 47-45. For Joe Onosai, this is Jim Leahy wishing you the best. Next week, the Rainbows take on Nevada Las Vegas. Hope you can be with us for that one from Aloha Stadium. Until then, malama pono, everybody. And remember, Kauai.
This KHNL sports presentation is sponsored by Budweiser, the king of beers, who reminds you, friends know when to say when.
Services have been provided by the following in exchange for promotional consideration. Tory Richard Cook Street, Kaehi Ice House, and the Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Hawaii.
This has been a presentation of Hawaii's very own KHNL, Channel 13.
あら、大丈夫です。三人よろどうですか。
バッハよろどいちです。
食べましょう。
はい。
刺身。
はい。
天ぷら。
はい。
握り寿司。
はい。
アヒオプ。
Oh, so that's 20 combinations number 3?
Yeah, 19. I want
sizzling rib steak, medium well with a side order of fries.
Banquets, meetings, large groups. When you want to get the clan together, try the Wisteria Restaurant.
What's going on? It's a meeting of the men's club. Men's club? What's that?
It looks like a bunch of guys having a good time watching TV, and they're not watching the show.
Typical. Can't make a commitment.
Well, they don't have time for those complex storylines.
So?
Well, they want to just jump right into the big action of Elwood. The classic laughs of the Odd Couple and the wacky humor of Newhart.
You seem to know an awful lot about the men's club.
Well, they may call it the men's club, but I watch it too.
Join the men's club, weekdays at noon on KHNL 13. You're watching Hawaii's very own KHNL Channel 13, transmitting from the Hilton Hawaiian Village, home of the Golden Dragon Restaurant. This concludes another day of broadcasting from Hawaii's very own KHNL Channel 13, a division of King Broadcasting Company. The studios and offices for KHNL are located at 150B Fu'uhale Road in Honolulu. The transmitter is located atop the Hilton Hawaiian Village Hotel in Honolulu. KHNL programming may be viewed in Hilo on KHBC TV Channel 2, in Wailuku on KOGG Channel 15, and on Kauai by tuning to UHF Translator Station K65BV. Thank you for watching. Aloha and good night.